My name is James Lonan and I am from India. I am the youngest of my family, and although it was difficult for me to leave my family, I came to United States 1997 for religious formation to be a priest.
La madre, el padre de James, se enfermaron y fallecieron. Él no pudo salir para estar con ellos. Hoy, 12 años después, habiendo terminado sus estudios teológicos y estando listo para ser sacerdote, por su estado migratorio no ha podido ser ordenado. Por años, James ha tenido el deseo en su corazón de servirle al pueblo de Dios como sacerdote.
Thank you.
name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. My brothers and sisters, peace be with you. Welcome to our Cathedral of Our Lady the Angels for our celebration of the Mass for Immigrants. Bienvenidos todos a la Catedral de Nuestra Señora de los Ángeles esta tarde para la celebración de la Misa de los Inmigrantes. It is a moment of grace for all of us as we gather this afternoon for the celebration of this Holy Mass, asking especially for God's grace that we have the blessing of having a comprehensive immigration reform soon. En este momento de gracia para todos nosotros y especialmente pedimos para que haya ya pronto la reforma migratoria comprensiva en nuestro país. We especially pray today for all immigrants. So, rezamos especialmente por todos los inmigrantes en nuestro país. So, let us start a celebration, acknowledging our sins and preparing ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery.
Thank you.
and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that they be fervent in hope, faith, and charity. They may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord appeared to Abraham at the pyramid of Ramah as he sat in the entrance of his tent. While the day was pouring on, looking up, Abraham saw three men standing in the water. When he saw them, he ran to the entrance of the tent to greet them. And bowing to the ground, he said, "Sir, if I may ask you this favor, please do not go on past your servant. Let some water be brought, that you may bathe your feet, and then rest yourselves under the tree. Now that you've come this close to your servant, let me bring you a little food, that you may refresh yourselves, and afterward you may go on your way." The man replied, "Very well, do as you said." Abraham hastened into the tent and told Sarah, "Quick, three measures of fine flour, knead it and make rolls." He ran to the herd, picked out a tender, choice steer, and gave it to his servant, who quickly prepared it. Then Abraham blessed the birds and them, as well as the steer that had been prepared, and set these before the three men. And he waited on them under the tree while they ate. They asked Abraham, "Where's your wife Sarah?" He replied, "There in the tent." One of them said, "I will surely return to you about this time next year, and Sarah will then have a son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. porque así completo lo que falta la pasión de Cristo en mí por el bien de su cuerpo, que es la iglesia. Por disposición de Dios, yo he sido constituido ministro de esta iglesia para predicarles por entero su mensaje. O sea, el designio secreto que Dios ha mantenido oculto desde siglos y generaciones y que ahora ha revelado a su pueblo santo.
But he doesn't know that every person is made in the image and likeness of God. Abraham, en la primera lectura, recibe a los extranjeros con su corazón abierto. No sabía que venían de parte de Dios. Please stand for confession. I believe in one God, the Father of God, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages. Let us now join in offering him our prayers and petitions.
For the Holy Father, Pope Francis, our bishops, priests, and deacons, 请为教宗光在国，我们的主教、神父和执事们祈祷，愿他们以主的恩宠牧养和照顾信众的需要。 Let us pray to the Lord.
Members of Congress, that they find the wisdom to pass just and compassionate, comprehensive immigration reform. Let us pray to the Lord.
For all who have died, that might enjoy eternal rest and peace in the kingdom of heaven, let's pray to the Lord. Per tutti quelli che sono morti perché godano della pace eterna nel regno dei cieli, let us pray to the Lord.
Father, with confidence and trust, we place these prayers before you. We offer them through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion various offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy. That you bless the gifts of table, so that what each has offered to the honor for your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our dear and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruit of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said it blessed, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. The mystery of faith. Holy Spirit, they become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Archbishop, and his assistant bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you under passing of this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, who we bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you. from Our Lady of Grace Parish. I was born in Guatemala, and my parents brought me here when I was 6 years old. Growing up, I noticed all the things my friends did that I couldn't do, such as visit family in foreign countries, go on our 8th grade Washington, D.C. trip, and get a driver's license. Why? Because I was undocumented. My senior year of high school, I knew I was not going to be able to go to some of the best colleges in the country. Not only because I did not want to be far from my family, but because I could not get on an airplane since I had no documents. And then President Obama announced deferred action last year. In September, my parents got a lawyer and my sister and I applied for deferred action. By November, we both had our permits, our social security numbers, and our California IDs. Now that I had legal documents, my mother said to me, "You're applying to Harvard and you're going there." I looked at her and said, "Mom, you're crazy. Only geniuses go to Harvard, and I am not a genius." She looked at me and said, "You are." Now, it is true that mothers are always right, and my mom was right. We talked about it every single day. She always encouraged me to apply, and I would always say no. I didn't think I was good enough. After about a month of this, I decided I might as well take a shot, since nothing, not even my legal status here, was holding me back anymore. Thanks to deferred action, I got an ID that gave me the opportunity to travel freely throughout the country on an airplane. So I applied to 13 universities. Out of the 13, I was accepted to 7, and one of those, surprisingly, was Harvard. So Mom, thank you so much for making me apply. Because not only did I get in, but I was also awarded a full scholarship. With God's help, I hope to graduate from there in 4 years with a bachelor's degree. Thank you.
Como padre, siempre tenemos grandes sueños para nuestros hijos. Y fue por eso que mi esposo y yo tomamos la decisión de traer a nuestros hijos cuando eran pequeños, no pensando en los obstáculos que ellos encontrarían por el hecho de ser indocumentados. El último obstáculo que vivimos fue que, a pesar de ser una excelente alumna, nuestra hija no podría ir a las mejores universidades del país por ser indocumentada. Hasta que, como una bendición de Dios, recibimos la acción diferida. Ahora estamos celebrando que nuestra hija va con una beca completa a la Universidad de Harvard.
Soy Alejandro Salazar, juez auxiliar de la Universidad de Los Ángeles, encargado de la Oficina de Vida, Justicia y Paz. De veras, el gran llamado del señor arzobispo a la oración es algo importantísimo, porque de aquí comienza todo y con Dios todo se va a hacer posible para el bien de todos. Así que, thank you very much for your presence here today. And remarking on the words of our Archbishop, calls us to prayer first and foremost. It is in prayer and rooted deeply in prayer that we're able to really trust in Almighty God, that His will be done, and that the good of all will be respected and become a reality. I wish to thank Bishop Virgilio de Diego and the people of the Diocese of San Bernardino for your presence here today. Also Bishop Dominic Wong and the people of the Diocese of Orange, I believe there are about 8 buses of people from Orange that are here today. Thank you so very much. We've also been working on meeting with our elected officials in Congress, not only in Los Angeles, but also in Orange and San Bernardino. We have organized teams of bishops, pastors, deacons, religious, and lay people that Holy Father Francis has really spoken about this when he went to visit the people of the island of La Medusa just last week. And he spoke about where are we and where is our brother or sister? Words that God asked the first man and words that God asked Cain. Those words come to us as well. Where are we? And what are we doing or what are we not doing to really ease the plight of our brothers and sisters who are in need? Have we taken the time to really walk in the moccasins of our brothers and sisters, to feel their pain,
Bishop Salazar and the Bishop of Life, Justice, and Peace for helping us to coordinate this beautiful celebration. Bishop, thank you very much. Thank Bishop Clark and Daniel Mahoney for being here today and helping us in this beautiful celebration. Reforma de inmigración pase cuanto antes. And we have a comprehensive immigration reform soon, now, as soon as possible. So let's keep praying and being active in asking that to happen in our country. We have God on our side. I'm not sure that the Lakers or the Dodgers have God on their side, but we do. So we have to have a lot of, now have Lakers and Clippers, so it gets a little complicated. But we have the certainty that with the help of the grace of God and our prayers and our action is going to happen. So, que viva la Virgen de Guadalupe!
Que viva!
Que viva San Juan Diego!
Que viva!
Que viva Cristo Rey! Charity and peace.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.